Hi, I'm Dr. Rick Lumpkin. I'm the Scientific Director of the Global Drifter Program component here at NOAA AOML. Here at AOML, we maintain a global array of satellite track drifting buoys that measure ocean currents and ocean temperatures. The data are used worldwide for climate research, for understanding how the ocean moves and how the ocean carries heat. We also gather the data from the instruments, quality control that, and distribute that for researchers worldwide. The Global Drifter Program began in 1979 with satellite-tracked surface drifting buoy observations in the tropical Pacific intended to understand the El Niño phenomenon. Through the 1980s, the instrument continued to evolve and was deployed in the Atlantic and Indian Oceans and then in the Southern Ocean until eventually we had a worldwide array of over 1,000 drifting buoys measuring ocean currents and surface temperatures. The satellite track drifter has a drogue hanging below a surface float. The drogue, or sea anchor, is centered at a depth of 15 meters to minimize the effect of wind on the drifter and so that the drifter measures the ocean currents near the surface. Near the surface, the float has a thermistor, or thermometer, which measures ocean temperatures. The data, the position, and the temperature are transmitted via satellite to land stations where we receive them in near real time, typically with less than an hour's delay. A large number of drifters in the array also measure barometric pressure, and these data are used to improve weather forecasting efforts. This is particularly valuable in large stretches of the Southern Oceans and North Pacific, where there are very few land-based weather stations. These data are invaluable for very accurate maritime weather forecasting efforts. In this schematic, you can see ocean surface currents, which have been mapped out by the surface drifters. A current is like a river in the sea, and they're interconnected across the basins so that within the North Atlantic we have this large clockwise swirling gyre. The same thing happens in the central Pacific here, and north of those there is a counter-rotating gyre known as the subpolar gyre. These currents have major impacts for ocean climate. For example, they can carry large amounts of heat from the equator to the high latitude regions. The classic example of this is the Gulf Stream system, consisting of the Loop Current, Florida Current, and Gulf Stream, which carry warm waters from the tropical Atlantic up to the high latitudes of the Atlantic Ocean, where it warms the air and changes very strongly the climate over Europe before it sinks and forms deep water currents flowing to the south. Drifters have also allowed us to collect measurements in places such as the Northwest Indian Ocean, where piracy activity makes it very hard to operate research vessels. Because drifters map ocean surface currents, they also map where particles floating on the ocean surface will be carried. As an example of their use for this, surface drifters were deployed after the Deepwater Horizon oil spill to observe what connectivity of different ocean patterns existed within the Gulf of Mexico, and thus to see whether particles in the northern Gulf of Mexico would be rapidly carried towards South Florida. Drifters were also deployed off of the coast of Japan after the earthquake and tsunami in Fukushima, in which a large amount of debris was released into the ocean and subsequently traveled across the Pacific. Hurricane drifters are a specific type of drifter which measure temperatures at the surface and also beneath the ocean surface. They are packaged within boxes connected to parachutes and air deployed from Air Force C-130Js in the paths of incoming hurricanes, typically a day ahead of arrival of the storm. As the storm passes, the drifters measure and give us information about the temperature changes, wind changes, and pressure changes, allowing us to improve weather forecasts and also improve models for the intensity of storms.
My name is Sean Dulk. I work within the Global Drifter Program, managing the operations and logistics, where I'm responsible for deploying drifters throughout the world's oceans. Here we have a map of the current drifter array, which notes the current location of every drifter in the ocean. You'll notice the drifters marked blue represent drifters with barometric pressure as well as sea surface temperature, whereas drifters marked in red do not have the barometric pressure. They only measure sea surface temperature. And drifters marked green represent drifters with salinity sensors. We incorporate the number of functional sensors and the age of each drifter to generate the drifter deployment value map, which we created here at AOML. The value map tells us where we need drifters based on these sensors and age criterion. The blue represents areas where drifters are needed, high-value deployment location, whereas areas in red represent either shallow ocean basins or areas where we currently have high-value drifters transmitting quality data. One of the main goals of the drifter program is to achieve spatial coverage throughout the world's ocean. We achieve to have one drifter approximately every 350 square miles. In order to do so, we collaborate with numerous agencies around the world, and we use tools such as the Drifter Deployment Value Map.